Hey guys, welcome back. So I was going to do a video on top versus bottom balancing and balancing methods, but I think that topic has been covered well enough. So I thought, why not make a video on how the BMS balances cells in real time? So for your visual learners, this one is for you. And we're going to do it time trial style. Along the way, you will see two different balancing methods: raw parallel pack and series pack with a BMS. If you use a plug-in charger like this one to regularly charge up your battery, you will want to watch this video. For this test, we'll be using two sets of cells. One set will be matched and the other set will be mismatched, as that is how they come from overseas suppliers. We're going to see how the BMS deals with each set. I think you'll find the results surprising. At the end of the video, we will cover basic cell buying tips. Let's get started. All right guys, so here are the cells we're going to be using for our tests. These are all currently charged to a 40% state of charge, or exactly 3.33 volts, or 66 amp hours / 220 watt hours. So for the two tests we'll be running, we're going to be running a match test and a mismatch test. For the match test, we want to pick the closest matched cells. For our matched set, it's pretty much a no-brainer here. We're going to go with the 971s. And the 972 right here. Eight cells left. We are going to pick two 973s. And we're going to pick a 966 for our low side. And we're going to pick the old 980 for our high side. And this will make up our mismatched set. All right, so these are the cells we're going to use for our testing. You can see they are perfectly matched. 298 amp hours, 971 watt hours. 298, 971, 298, 971, 298, 972. So these are very, very matched, not just at the amp hour level, but at the watt hour level, because there's about 3 watt hours for every amp hour. So these should balance very, very nicely. And but we want to connect them in parallel, and then we're going to use Big Blue to quick charge them up to 3.40, and from there we will plug in the BMS and continue charging up to 3.65. So right now we just want to do a quick voltage check. 3.317, 3.322, 3.321, 3.317. All right, so they are very, very close enough. So first thing we need to do is connect these in parallel. Remember to always check the cell voltage that they are equal before connecting the bus bars. I will not be torquing the nuts to spec for this test. Snug should be fine as we are charging with 40 amps. So for our charging, we're going to do a diagonal charge so that we can get even charging throughout the pack versus going from here to here. Our positive lead will go here. And our negative will go over here. And then we'll connect our reference here. So you can see now we're reading a total pack voltage of 3.317. And now we are going to program Big Blue. We want to do charge, constant voltage. And we're going to do a 40 amp charge. And we're going to stop at 3.40. Cutoff current, 0.50 amps. That should be okay. And here we go. We're going to start charging and we're going to see when it stops. During bulk phase, the charger will deliver its maximum current of 40 amps. The applied voltage will increase to its maximum voltage, or bulk voltage. During absorption, the voltage is constant. The current will steadily decrease down to zero. Finally, float. Charge voltage drops and holds at lower voltage. This keeps the battery topped off. Okay, now on to the mismatched set. Let's do a quick voltage check. 3.283, 3.279, 3.279, 3.283. Now we can safely connect these in parallel. Next, we can fire up Big Blue. She's very hungry. So we're going to do constant voltage at a 40 amp charge. We're going to charge to 3.40 volts, and our cutoff will be 0.5 amps. And ready? Here we go. The vertical lines are from stopping and starting the charge process. It does not affect the total runtime or the test in any way. So now we have both packs charged up to 3.40 volts using Big Blue at 40 amps. This is our matched set here, and this is our mismatched set over here. So check this out. This pack, I finished charging this, I think, one day ago, maybe 2 days ago. So it's had time to settle in voltage. So as time goes on, the voltage will settle down. This one I just finished charging, so the voltage hasn't had time to settle down, but the overall voltage on these cells is still lower than these cells. For the match set, you can see we're going to have 3.350 across the board, 3.350, 3.350. Now we go to the mismatch set, look at this, 3.33. See, it's not as high. 3.33. Let's just say 3.34. So 3.34 versus 3.35. This pack was on the charger longer than this pack. So you can see that this cell is limiting this pack from reaching its voltage. And we haven't even gotten to the BMS testing yet. Let's take a look at the charge charts.
So the matched set was on the charger for 27 hours, 45 minutes. The mismatched set for 28 hours even. We ended up with 675 amp hours or 2.29 kilowatt hours for the matched set and 627 amp hours or 2.12 kilowatt hours for the mismatched set, with an average voltage of 3.35 and 3.34 respectively. Remember, both sets started with 66 amp hours in each cell before charging with Big Blue. Let's move on to the BMS testing.
All right, so then now that we have our cells charged up to 3.40 volts, we're going to use our plug-in charger to charge it up the rest of the way. But before we do that, we need to connect up the BMS.
We must flip the cells in order to create a series configuration.
Let's install the bus bars.
And now our bus bars are installed.
Now we'll do a quick voltage test. So we have 13.34 volts. Next we'll connect up the harness.
In order to keep this video on topic, I'm going to speed through connecting the BMS. If you want to learn more, you can find a detailed battery build video in the description below.
At this point, we should be able to turn on our BMS. There it is, we're reading 13.4 volts.
And this is the charger we will be using for our BMS charging test. It is a 12 volt plug-in charger made by Ampere Time. Plug-in chargers will charge to the full 14.6 volts or 3.65 volts per cell. The charger has four modes indicated by a status LED: waiting mode, charge mode, full charge mode, or charge air mode. A solid green LED indicates standby or waiting mode, typically seen when the charge is complete or the charger is powered on but not charging. A red LED indicates that the charger is in charging mode. A red-green flashing LED indicates a charge error has occurred, such as an OVP or overvoltage protection error triggered by the BMS. Full charge is also indicated by a green LED. This occurs on a successful charge and top-off. The problem that can occur while using this type of charger is that if the BMS goes into overvoltage protection mode and shuts off charging, the charger will go into error mode, and you might think something is wrong with your battery, when in fact it is just waiting for the BMS to balance the cells so that it can continue charging. Let's go over the test setup. We have both sets side by side, time trial style. Each BMS screen has a timer. The timer is the total runtime from when the charger was first applied until we get a successful top-off charge. The images in the middle will change from time to time during the test. the speed will increase and decrease as key moments occur. We will want to focus on the BMS screens on the left and right. This is what we want to watch for. Battery pack voltage. This needs to get to 14.6 volts for a complete charge, without the charger or BMS going into air mode. Remain battery or state of charge. Average cell voltage. Generally, at 3.40 volts, the balancer will typically start running. Below 3.4 volts is bulk mode, no balancing. This can depend on the quality of your cells. Cell voltage difference, or delta. This is the difference between the highest and lowest cell. When the delta reaches 0.010 volts or greater, the BMS will trigger the balancer to start balancing. Cell voltage for each cell. OVP will occur when any one cell reaches 3.70 volts or greater. Notice the state of charge for each pack. These were charged at the same rate with Big Blue, and they are not equal. The match set is at 75% and the mismatch set at 72%. We will witness four phases in this test. Bulk mode until 3.40 volts. This will be at 32 times speed. Charge attempt and fail due to overvoltage protection at 16x speed. Cell balancing down to 3.45 volts at 16x speed. Final push and top off, real time. Please note, the match set BMS screen on the left will seem choppy and fast, as I lost much of the footage due to BMS connection failure during screen recording. The mismatched BMS screen on the right shows very clearly the different phases and more accurately represents a typical charge and balance scenario. Let the games begin! My commentary will be focused on the right-hand screen, so we're not switching back and forth to avoid confusion. So right now the cell voltages are still rather low, so we're going to be charging in bulk mode and the balancer is not needed at this point. We just hit 84% state of charge with the mismatch set. So our average voltage is nearing 3.40 volts on the mismatch set. Soon it will trigger the balancer. Now we have a balanced start. Delta is greater than 0.010. Notice how the matched pack on the left is already hitting an OVP alarm. It's already further along in the process than the one on the right, the mismatch set. It's only 6 hours and 30 minutes on the left versus 7 hours and 23 minutes on the right. So on the right hand side, we can see the delta is rising. That means that the cells are starting to drift. Once that happens, we're going to get an OVP error. Once it hits 3.70, it'll throw an OVP error. So the BMS is not able to keep that cell under control. And now we got an OVP alarm, and the charger went into air mode. Now we're attempting to charge. Another OVP. This process will continue over and over and over until the cells are balanced. So now we're doing the final balance on the mismatch set. Notice how the delta is decreasing. And we currently are not receiving any charge from the charger. This is actually the proper way. On the match set, I was trying to kick the charger, and it prevented the cells from settling down quicker. So it would have probably completed even faster if I had to keep on interrupting it. Now we're balanced. Now we're charging. Now we're going to make our final attempt to get 3 to get to 14.6 volts or 3.65 volts per cell without going into error mode. 0.4 amps. 0.2 amps, are we gonna make it? Almost there. There it is.
Wow, that was crazy. The BMS was able to handle both sets of cells beautifully, but what exactly happened? Let's take a closer look.
All right, here we have our mismatched set of cells. The capacity label position represents the cell's physical or true capacity. The green fill represents the cell's state of charge, 100% being 3.65 volts. In order for the pack to reach 14.6 volts, each cell must be charged to 3.65 volts. How can that happen if the cells have different capacity? The JK BMS is equipped with a 2-amp active balancer. In active balancing, the BMS moves energy from the lower capacity cells to the larger capacity cells when charging. Here, we can see where cell number 4 was running away from the other cells and triggered an OVP error. Here is where we can see the BMS in action, as it's moving excess energy from cell number 4 to the other cells. The average voltage for all cells is now 3.607. Now we see the BMS make the final push to 3.65 volts and top off the cells. In passive balancing, the pack will be limited to the lowest capacity cell, and it would look something like this. Excess energy is bled off in the high cells in the form of heat via resistive load. So with the match set, cells number 2 and number 3 went high, and then it took a while for the BMS to bleed off the excess energy, as it had nowhere to go since all the cells are well matched. I was expecting the BMS to bring cell number 1 up to the level of the other cells, but apparently that's not how it likes to operate. I kept restarting the charger, trying to force cell number 1 up to the level of the other cells. Finally, I gave up and just let it sit, and all the cell voltages settled down to 3.65 volts. The BMS considered it balanced, and we were able to get a clean charge. I think it's possible for the match set to finish a lot faster. I'll have to do an update video and retest it.
Cells purchased from China will not be matched, so you may not have the luxury of hand-picking matched cells. This is normal and perfectly fine as long as you follow some basic cell buying tips. Do not buy cells of differing capacity and or manufacturer to put in the same pack. Only buy from reputable companies. See the description for my recommendation. Confirm with the supplier that the internal resistance of all cells are the same. Ask the supplier if the cells are from the same batch. Check the data sheet for the cells and be sure that the C rate is suitable for your application. For a 12-volt battery, you will want at least a 1 C rate continuous discharge. And remember, if the price is too low, it's probably too good to be true. Unfortunately, I cannot say how the BMS remembers each cell's individual capacity for subsequent cycles, or if it even does. It's possible that once balanced, the balancer is all that's needed, but I find that hard to believe. If anyone knows, please let me know in the comments below. I have one idea on how it happens, so I'll be doing a follow-up video shortly. And as always, thanks for watching.